students, welcome to business studies class. So successfully we are completed the part first of business study. So there are 8 chapters. So from first to last, first to 8, we are completed the things. Okay. So now from today onwards, we are going to start the business study part second. And from business study part second, first chapter is financial management. So chapter number 9 is financial management. So, what is the financial management? So, name itself indicates what is being financial management. So, finance means you can follow money or capital. And management, what is the management? You already learned within the first chapter. Okay. So, finance means how we can manage the money for a business. So, all of you know money is like a blood for business. So, any kind of business, it may be a small, medium, or large size. A production industry, and otherwise it may be a service industry. Okay, so whatever it may be, if you are going for a business, the basic need to do any kind of business is a money. Okay, so money, it is an important factor required to run any kind of business, and management of that money, that is also very important. If you are not able to manage a proper money, what you got a fund, otherwise what you have capital to run your business, if you not use a proper utilization of that money, so there may be the chances to loss to your business. Okay, otherwise there may be the wasting of money. So you have to use whatever you have the money, otherwise whatever you have the capital, so proper use of that capital is a very important, otherwise there may be the chances of risk, or you can call them losses. Okay, so due to the inefficient management, so you should not face such problems. So that's why proper utilization of money, proper utilization of finance, that is a very important thing, and this things we are going to learn in this chapter. Means whatever you have the money, how you are going to manage that money, how you are going to use of that money without wasting that money. So that thing we are going to learn in this video. Okay. So first we have to see what is mean business finance. So business means all of you know now. So finance means what? Finance means in shortly you know money, or you can call the fund or capital required for a business. So what is the financial business finance? So money required to carry out business activities. So what is the business finance? So whatever money or capital or funds required to carry out the business activities. So when you are carrying your business, there are lot of activities are there, maybe the planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, otherwise purchasing of raw material, okay, distribution of the products, means purchasing, procurement, storage. These are all the activities included within the business activities. So to carry out, to run these activities, you require money. Okay. So what are the activities of business? It may be any purchasing of raw materials, storage, procurement of products, otherwise you can call the distribution of the product. So whatever these activity, business activities are there, to run these business activities, you require money. Okay, for that money you are going to call as a business finance. Okay, next one, what is given? The business finance, so it requires to run the business. Means whatever money required to run your business, for that money you can call it business finance. Next thing is to expand the business. Only to carry out a business, whatever money you require, that not mean the business finance. As well as to increase, to grow, or to survive of your business. So for that also money is required. Okay, to expand your business means in an initial stage you are doing your business with a small scale. If you want to increase it to medium scale industry, so then what medium scale business, so that time you require extra money. Okay, to expand your business also, for growth of your business also, you require money. So for that money also we can call the business finance. Next one, buying assets. Means if you are running your business, you require a fixed assets, or you can call the working assets. Okay, so whatever money required to buy the asset, to purchase the asset. Take example, for your business, you required some furnitures, you required some machineries. Okay, so whatever it may be, the assets you required, buildings, these are the assets, these are the fixed assets. Okay, so these are the assets required for your business. Without that assets, you are not able to carry your business. So these assets are very essential for business. Take example, maybe laptop if it is required, maybe other machineries are required, furnitures are required, proper storage capacity you should require, or buildings, or you can call room. Okay, so these assets you are required for your business. And to purchase that asset, to take that asset, to buy that asset, you require a money. Okay, so that is also comes under the business finance. Because whatever assets required for your business, for to purchase that asset, you require a money, and that money is also known as a business finance. Next one is day-to-day operations. Okay, so if you start your business, that means requirement of money is not going to end at that point. Okay, you start your business and you invested your money for purchasing of assets. When you purchase your machineries, okay, you purchase furnitures, you purchase buildings. Okay, so up to that much you are required money, that is okay. But after that also you have to require of money. Means for what? So day-to-day operation. So day-to-day operations means what? Daily you have to purchase a raw material. So suppose it is a production industry, you have to purchase a raw material daily basis. So money required to purchase a raw material. So that comes under the day-to-day operations. Otherwise, who are workers are working within your organization, otherwise within your industry, employees, you have to give a salary to your employees. It may be your daily wages, otherwise it may be a salary. So it comes under the day-to-day operations. Otherwise maybe the paying of rent, okay, paying of bill, okay, paying of any receipt, okay, otherwise the transportation cost may be there. So day-to-day life also you require money. So for that also you require money. For that money also you can call a business finance. Next, money is blood for a business. So that's why for each step, for each day you require the money to run your business. For that, so that's why money is a blood for a business. How it is a blood is working for our human body. So similar, money is like a blood for a business. Okay, so that's why money, it is a very important capital, it is a very important for a business or day-to-day life. So to carry out each activity you require money. So that's why money is a blood for a business. And whatever money required to run a business, for day-to-day operations, to purchase of assets, to expand your business, okay, for whatever these activities are there, for all activities money is required. For that money you can call a business finance. Okay, so for each activity you require a money. So that's why proper utilization of money is also very important thing. If you not manage, if you not utilize your money properly, so there will be the chances of losses or risk. So we have to minimize the risk, we have to minimize the loss. So that's why proper utilization of resources, otherwise proper utilization of money, it is very, very important thing. So next, financial management. Why we are required the financial management? We have money, so day-to-day operation we are giving that money. So proper management, why it is required? So it is very important for the proper management. So how? So efficient acquisition of fund. So efficiency means also you know. So efficient acquisition of funds means, see, to run your business, you are investing your individual money, that is a owner's fund. Okay. Otherwise you are borrowing money from the banks. Okay. When you are borrowing money from the banks, you have to pay the interest. Okay. Otherwise you are taking the shareholders' you are taking money from the shareholders. Okay. Otherwise, from debentures. Yes. Otherwise, any financial institutions. So these are the ways. These are the ways from that way you are acquire for money. Okay. From these are the ways. One, you should invest your owner's fund. Otherwise, go for the shareholders fund. Otherwise, debentures. Otherwise, you should take a loan from bank. So these are the resources to generate a fund for your business. So efficient acquisition of funds is also very important, because see, all of you know, when you take a loan from a bank, if you are taking a loan for 100 rupees, is it right? If you are taking a loan from a bank, you are taking 100 rupees from a bank. But when you are paying that loan, okay, when you are paying that debt, so you have to pay your capital amount plus interest rate. You have to pay this much amount, you have to pay to return to your bank. Okay, when you are investing your individual money, so that time you are paying to itself interest rate? No. Because for your business only you are invested that money. Yes, when you are borrowing money from a bank, you have to pay the interest rate. Okay, when you are taking the money from debentures, so that time also you have to pay the interest rate. Okay, otherwise if you are taking a shares, if you have sold out your company's shares to shareholders, so you are sold out in 100 rupees one share. For 100 rupees one share you are sold out in. But when you are giving, so per year you have to pay the dividend. You have to pay the dividend. Yes, but that time you have to pay only dividend from the capital amount. Yes, but when you are taking a loan from a bank, you have to pay the capital amount plus interest rate. When you are taking a money from debentures, you have to pay capital amount plus interest rate. But when you are taking a money from the shareholders, per year you have to pay dividend only, not the capital amount. Yes, so which is helpful if you compare with a loan from a bank, loan from a debentures? But which is suitable? So shareholders are suitable, because per year you have to pay the dividend. But when your company under the loss, so that time only you have to pay the capital amount. Otherwise there is no need to pay the capital amount to your shareholders. Okay. But per year, up to whenever your companies are going to be run, so up to that much you have to pay the dividend to your shareholders. Okay, but that time your capital amount, it is secured there. Yes, so for each source, there will be the extra amount is going to be given out to your debentures, or you can call the shareholders or from the bank. Okay, so which is the sufficient, which is efficient source? So that source you have to utilize to generate a fund for your business. Means you have to choose which is suitable for your business. If you take a loan from a bank, it is suitable. Go for taking a loan from a debentures, it is suitable. Go for it. So otherwise, selling out the shares, selling the shares, it is suitable for your business. Go for it. Means which is efficient source to acquire a fund? That source you have to choose for your business. So in this case, so interest rate is, it is a low, so dividend rate is a small amount, so it is a suitable. But shareholders are interfering within the business activities, so it may have an advantage, one disadvantage. So choice is yours. So whichever source, whichever way you are choosing to acquire a fund, so that should be efficient manner. Yes, which is easy and which is with the less cost. So that source you should acquire for your business. Secondly, efficient utilization of funds. So So funds are generated. Once funds are generated, so what are the funds are there? What are the capitals are there? So you should use that capital in proper way. Means efficient way. You should use that funds proper way or efficient way. So there should not be any wastage of funds there. Okay. Next one, efficient distribution of surplus. Yes. First word, the thing, how much you are taking a money, otherwise which source you are selecting to generate a fund. So that should be efficient. Second thing, whatever amount you got for your business, whatever amount is generated for your business, so efficient use of it. Means for within the asset, how much you are investing, within the day-to-day operation, how much you are investing. So that should be within the proper planning, proper management should be there. Next thing, whatever surplus amount it is there. So distribution of surplus amount, that is also very important. So surplus amount means what? Suppose you required 100 rupees for your business. Okay. So by using it, maybe you are taken a loan from a bank, otherwise you are taken a from debentures, otherwise you are selling the shares. Okay. So any method you generated this amount. Okay. So after the proper utilization of amount means from 100 rupees. So from 100 rupees to purchase a raw material, you are given 5 rupees. Okay. For to day-to-day operation, you are given 50 rupees. Okay. Another maybe the transportation cost 5 rupees. This is the example. Okay. So 5 rupees. So from 100 rupees, you pay 50 plus 60 rupees are you pay. Otherwise, you utilize the 60 rupees. So what is the amount left? So 40 rupees is the amount left. So that is the surplus. That is the surplus. So what is the 40 rupees amount is left? So what you are going to use, for what purpose you are going to use that 40 rupees? So that is the proper distribution of surplus. Means take example, suppose mother or father, they are given a pocket money to you. Okay, so they are given pocket money to you. So after means what utilization of that money, there will be the some money, it is left over with you. Okay, so that is the surplus amount. And what you are going to do that amount, you are returning to your mother or father, otherwise you are going for the saving of it, otherwise you are going to purchase something. So that is your decision. So proper distribution of surplus, that is also very important. If you are investing within the business, that amount, once again, if you want to invest within the business, otherwise if you want to purchase any asset, so that is your owner's decision. Okay, so that is proper distribution of surplus also very important. So next concept is objectives of financial management. So to do a financial management, what is the main motive? Why we should go for the financial management? What is the aim to go for the financial management? So first one, they are the wealth maximization. Wealth, or you can call them profit management, property maximization. Wealth maximization of what? So maximize the shareholders' wealth. Shareholders wealth. So who are shareholders? Who are to run our business? The common people are given a money to us. Okay? On the name of shares. They are purchasing our shares, our company shares. So they are our shareholders. So instead of that, they are given a money, they are given a fund for our business. So if they are given a money to us, means per year we have to pay the dividend to our shareholders. Is it right? Per year we have to pay the dividend to our shareholders. So we try to increase the dividend rate. Suppose if your share price is 100 rupees and if you are given 20% of dividend, means for 100 who are paid 100 rupees to us, so we are giving a 20 rupees per year to our shareholders. So to increase the dividend rate, so that is the main motto. Otherwise, to increase the wealth of our shareholders. Otherwise, to increase the dividend rate. So that is the main aim. Okay. Secondly, which is for the achievement of optimum capital structure and proper utilization of fund. So what is going to happen? So if you increase the dividend rate for the shares, so obviously the market price of your shares is going to be increased. automatically the maximum shareholders can be connected with us. So that's why wealth maximization of shareholder is very important. If you increase the dividend rate, when the dividend is rate is going to be increased? When your business is under the profit. So if your business is under the profit, your dividend rate is going to be increased. If the dividend rate is going to be increased, automatically the market price for your share value, it is going to be increased. So that is the main objective for the financial management. Next one. The next objective of financial management is to procure, or you can call to obtain, sufficient fund for organization. Okay, so second important objective of financial management is to obtain, otherwise to procure sufficient fund for organization. See, just I told to run your business to for day to day operation of your business, you are required a money. Okay, so regular and sufficient supply of funds should be there. So if you take a suppose you required a money funds for your business, okay, at initial stage, but whatever you required a money for your business, it is not only at initial stage. So day to day life you required a money for your business to run your business. So you have money at initial stage, but mid of the business, mid of the year, you don't have money. So that time you are not able to pay the, that time you are not able to manage the things, otherwise that time you are not able to operate the day-to-day operations. So whatever money you require for your business, at which point the money should be generated. Okay, so at this stage we have money, but after 2 months if we don't have money, so what is the use of it? So for day-to-day operations you require a money, so regular supply of money should be there, not at only one time. So there should be a regular and sufficient, there should be a regular and sufficient amount of money should be required for your business. You have money now, okay, but if you have not managed properly that money, so for day-to-day operations it is going to be faced the difficulty. So that's why financial management, it is very important. Just like hold the surplus amount. Okay, now you are left with 40 rupees, and if you are investing that 40 rupees and after 2 months you require money, and that time your parents are not giving you a money, so what you are going to do? You have requirement of money, but parents are not ready to give. So if you save that surplus, so that money you can use at that time. So that's why proper management of finance is very important. Next one, to ensure the efficient utilization of funds. Means whatever the funds are generated for your business, so for each activity, so you should use the efficient use of that fund for each activity of business. Next, to ensure the safety of funds, yes, only generation of money, only the distribution of efficient of money, it is not the thing, but always to ensure the safety of your funds, your money should be safe. So whatever the money generated, that should be safe. Means what? The chances of risk in investment should be minimum. See, all of you know, it is one of the character of business. So business risk. So we don't know what is going to be happening in future. Okay, we are not sure what will be going to be happening in future. We don't have the knowledge of it. So due to that thing, there will be the chances we are going to face some risk. Otherwise, there will be the chances of losses for your business. So when you are investing your money, you should go for the study of the thing. Otherwise, your money is not going to be safe. So security of your money, that is also important. Means you should try to find out the risk in each factor, and according to the risk factor, you have to invest your money. And last one, to attain optimum capital structure. Means what? A sound and economical combination of shares and debentures must be attained so as to maintain the optimum capital structure. Means how you are going to generate money for your business. One, you are going to take a loan from a bank, otherwise from a debentures, otherwise you are going to take a, you are selling the shares. Okay, otherwise you are collecting money from shareholders. So this thing should be your economic. this thing should be a economy. Means what is the interest rate on our shares? That should be a minimum. Okay, what you are paying a dividend to your shares, so that should be also minimum. But within the first objective, we have seen that the main objective of financial management to wealth maximization of your shareholders. Means we are try to give the more dividend to our shareholders, but there should be a balance. There should be sound and economic balance between shares and debentures. So if you make a balance between these things, so you are proper, you can obtain a optimum capital structure for your business. So I hope you got a clear concept about what is the financial management, why it is important, and what are the objectives of financial management. Suppose if you have any doubt, we will clarify your doubt within the live class. So thank you so much. Bye bye. Take care.